Next, breaking news moments ago, pro-Russian rebels handing over the black boxes from Malaysia Flight 17. Will there be a smoking gun? Plus, preventing the next Flight 17, should commercial passenger planes be equipped with anti-missile technology? And the rising death toll in the Middle East tonight, two Americans now killed fighting for Israel. Let's go out front. Everyone, I'm Erin Burnett. We begin out front tonight with the breaking news and the investigation of Malaysia Airlines Flight 17. Moments, pieces of fuselage moved. People were sawing into things. Impossible to tell motive at this point.
But very worrying.
Yeah, very worrying.
Very worrying. Because until we know...
Okay, so Mary, let me ask you, when you hear this and you also hear about the black boxes, the crucial question of tampering, though. Is there any chance these black boxes were tampered with
No.
in such a way that any of that could be removed?
No,
no, right?
Well, let's look at
a lot of information that could be on them, but not the information about who was on the ground and who did that. Just and how it transpired when the missile got near the plane.
And that's probably why.
And Michael, let me bring you in on that note in terms of the access to the site, whether there's been tampering with other parts of this front next. The evidence that links Russia to the downed jet. Does it go all the way up to Putin? Plus, is it time for all passenger jets to be equipped? Breaking news on the downing of Malaysia Airlines Flight 17. Pro-Russian rebels have just handed over the plane's black boxes to Malaysian investigators in Ukraine in a very carefully choreographed, literal handoff in front of reporters. This comes as the United States is trying to build a case directly against Russian President Vladimir Putin. Tonight, now the top Democrat on the House Foreign Affairs Committee, Congressman Elliot Engel, have said the shooting down of a passenger airline is, quote, an act of terror. Do you stand by those words?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and I know this is be very important in determining the world's response. So I want to get your make sure I really understand you on this. If it was unintentional, if they thought that they were shooting down a cargo plane or a Ukrainian military plane and shot this instead, if it was an accidental horrific, and obviously I can see you probably agree with some of what he's saying, but when you look at 9/11 as a terrorist act, obviously there was intent there, and the United States went to call it a terrorist act and then not go to war over it.
Well, I think what you call it in many ways is in fact, the world needs to take a united stand.
Listen, on the plane. And you're going to have the rest of the world and a lot of Europe who relies on their relationship with Russia say it was an accident. And they might use that to not support incredibly harsh sanctions. States, would you support the president taking a much tougher stand than he has?
Take a tough stand with him. I really believe that you confront a bully early on.
Prevent another Flight 17. Should passenger planes be equipped with anti-missile technology? Is it even a realistic thing to consider? Sarah Seidner's out front. Breaking news on Malaysia Airlines Flight 17. Just moments ago, pro-Russian rebels handed over the jets, two black boxes to Malaysian investigators in Ukraine. Those black boxes perhaps could tell us something about the plane's final moments. 298 passengers were on board that flight. Among them, 25. Earlier, we reported on the technology that would allow passenger jets to fire back at. But is that possible? How many other hot spots, war zones, are passengers flying over every single minute? Right now, an out-front investigation tomorrow night. Thanks so much for joining us. We'll see you back here tomorrow. Our continuing coverage of Malaysia 17 continues now with Anderson.